Coming up, President Trump made a campaign stop in Dubuque, the city of Dubuque received a grant to help plant trees around the area, and the Battle of the Key City took place. All this and more, up next.
Good evening and welcome to DBQ TV. I'm Kaeleb Lucero, he's Duane Vetter. It's been a busy time here in Dubuque. College is back in full swing and everywhere seems just a little bit busier.
I tell you what, Kaeleb, it sure is great to be back in Dubuque. Our top story this evening, former President Trump's campaign made a stop in Dubuque recently. It was a big day in downtown Dubuque for both those who love Trump and those who love to hate him. Former President Trump addressed a crowd of hundreds at the Grand River Center on Wednesday. He spoke to the audience about many topics with emphasis on illegal immigration and abortion. As bustling as it was inside, the area was just as busy outside. Protesters gathered at various corners outside the Grand River Center, holding signs and chanting, "How many indictments?" Trump's stop in Dubuque was the first of many stops in Iowa during his campaign that will conclude right before the Iowa caucuses begin.
One of the top tourist destinations in Dubuque is, of course, the scenic Riverwalk. However, those with a keen eye may notice something different when they're taking on a walk in the river. The Mississippi River water levels continue to drop. For the second year in a row, the river levels have fallen. The cause of this happening are the high temperatures and low rainfall that we continue to see all around Iowa. This is taking a toll on shipments traveling north and south on the Mississippi River, causing barge shipping companies to have restricted tow sizes along the lower and upper Mississippi River. Because of the restrictions of barges, farmers are having to pay more for their crops to be transported down to the Gulf of Mexico.
I know my buddies back home can't be happy about those higher shipping prices. On a more positive note, there is some good news for any dendrophiles in Dubuque.
Dendrophile, good word.
The city of Dubuque will be receiving a grant of over $1 million dedicated to planting trees around the city. The Urban and Community Forestry Grant, which totals $1.5 million, was granted to the city of Dubuque from the United States Forest Service. Dubuque is one of 400 communities to receive the Urban and Community Forestry Grant this year, which will bring over 6,600 new trees to the city throughout the next 5 years, which calculates to approximately 1,300 trees a year. Helping with tree installation will be the Dubuque Trees Forever members, civic organizations, and other volunteers from around the city. The Urban and Community Forestry Grant promises to turn Dubuque into a greener and more sustainable community over the next 5 years.
A Dubuque man found guilty of dealing drugs was sentenced to 4 years in a federal prison. Rashawn Carter was 46, sentenced after pleading guilty to selling cocaine and heroin within 1,000 feet of Loras College. Carter is being held in the U.S. Marshals custody awaiting transport to a federal prison. We'll head to a quick 30-second break to hear a word from our friends over at Tricor, followed up by our local sports report.
Growing your business, we know it's a lot of work. And there's no such thing as one size fits all when it comes to your insurance and financial services. Focusing on what you need has made Tricor one of the area's fastest growing insurance providers. Whether it's business insurance, employee benefits, risk and claims management, or safety services, we are your trusted business partner. That's why we're here to help.
Welcome back to DBQ TV. As you can tell, we've entered our sports segment here. Last Saturday, the Loras Dewhawks and the University of Dubuque Spartans faced off in the Key City Clash. Quarterback Evan England was 36 of 52 passing for 372 yards with two touchdown passes, both caught by wide receiver Monty Brown. Monty Brown also had 12 receptions for 58 yards. On the other side of Monty Brown was Jaheim Haynes, who had a spectacular 8 receptions for 161 yards. The Dewhawks had some momentum late, but ultimately fell to the Spartans. The University of Dubuque won the Key City Clash 35-23, and now we'll be talking to Ian about the game.
I would say just putting a full game together. Most of the games this year we've put in a good half, maybe a good 3 quarters, but we've never really put a full game together and been consistent throughout the whole game. So I'd say that's one thing we need to do.
Well, Ian, thank you for your time, and we look forward to next year's Key City Clash.
The Dubuque Fighting Saints are coming off a big 8-3 win at home against the Muskegon Lumberjacks. First period ended with a 3-2 lead for the Saints. The Saints proceeded to score 4 more times in the second period, putting up 5 goals going into the third. James Reeder, a forward for the Saints, made it an early 8-2 lead in the third period. The goal was assisted by Saints forward Jake Sunville. The Saints have an upcoming game this Friday against the Blackhawks, hosting them at 7 p.m. at Dubuque Ice Arena. We hope to see you there.
I think it's about time we wrap up our show. I'm feeling ready to get out of this silly thing.
Not feeling too hot after that Broncos game?
You know I'm not.
Thank you to Tricor for sponsoring today's segment. We thank you here at DBQ TV. We'll see you next time.